Ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. Cabaret 2018 is about to start. Now, will you welcome to the stage Charlotte Payne and Stuart Clark?
It's Keith and Ashley doing a reprise, well, doing an old sketch that you might be aware of with a new modern, when I say modern, old Russian literary
old lit Russian we've got a few sketches tonight. We've got some singing, we've got some dancing, we've got some poetry, we've got some monologues. So all join in, clap your hands and enjoy the cabaret.
Excuse me, miss. I'd like to make a complaint.
What's he calling, miss?
Sorry, I've had a head injury. I'd like to complain.
Close lunch.
Well, none of that. I'd like to complain about this seagull, which I bought not half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Yeah, what's your point? What's wrong with it?
It's dead! What's wrong with it?
No, it's just mourning for its life.
Mourning for its life?
Bird, beautiful plumage.
The plumage don't come into it. It is deceased.
It's just morning.
It ain't morning. All right, if it's morning, I'll wake it up. Hello, Mrs. Nina Seagull. Would you like some lovely cuttlefish for me?
Hey, I moved.
It didn't move. You just hit it. Yes, you did.
Never did anything. Didn't touch it.
Hello, Mrs. Nina Seagull. Testing, testing. This is your 5:30 call to Yell Yets. It is deceased.
Oh, now she's stunned. She's just waking up and then you stunned her. I should white stuns easily, you know, Major.
When I got it, you told me that its reason for not moving whatsoever is that it was tired and shagged out from doing a prolonged monologue.
Pining for the lake to which she is drawn.
Pining for the lake? I thought it only ended up flat on its back.
Oh, Russian white prefers on its back, especially after its two shots before lunch.
When I got it home, I took the liberty of investigating it. I found out the only reason it was on its perch is because it was nailed there.
Well, I had to nail it there. If I hadn't done that, it'd have nuzzled up to the cage, beak against the bars, and then whoop.
Woof! That bird would have woofed if you put 40,000 volts up its arse. It is deceased.
No, it's just mourning.
It ain't mourning. It is dead. It is gone. If it weren't bloody nailed, it'd be pushing up the daisy. It has fallen off the mortal coil. It has gone down the curtain and joined the choir invisible. It is an ex-seagull.
I suppose best replace it then. sorry, squad, I've had a look around back and we're fresh out of
I see.
I've got slug.
Pray, does it work as a metaphor? Is it both the banality of life and freedom itself? Is it a symbol and a parody of symbolism? Does it have subtext?
Yeah.
I'll take one.
So we forgot to announce that the lovely Jackie is offering a strip for a pound this evening.
Next to the stage, we've got LJ and Sarah, who are going to do a medley of hits from a hit TV programme. Do you want me to say the programme's name?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
From Crazy Ex-Girlfriend.
Hashtag humble and blessed. Newsflash, fuck what, I'm a good person. Do I
I'll do it. I'll gut him like a fish.
You're a good person.
Thank you. Such a good, real good person.
Well, the next song we can do is actually quite serious. So stop all the jokes. Oh, like there's no, we're gonna get serious now for a second because there's a really big issue.
Yeah, there is. It affects a lot of people. It's no way in the media as much as it should be. Quick glance around the room. You know, there's even some people here tonight who are affected
by
this.
I feel like it affects a lot of people in this room tonight.
Yeah. So we want to bring it down a notch. We want to shine some light on this issue because it's just not getting enough time right now.
Yeah, definitely. Let me just put my super serious hat on.
I'm ready. You ready? Okay.
I got them heavy boobs, dance like Diane Sarge. I got them heavy boobs, heavy boobs.
I can run real far.
Let me break down what I just said. Each of these double G's weighs the volume of a toddler's head. Now bitch about my boobies, they look super fly in shirts. But if I slap them in your face, you'd be like, oh my god, that hurts. I'm blind, holy crap, I literally can't see.
Memoirs.
What you gotta know is that boobs and where it's at. If you cut them open, they're just sacks of yellow fat. So if you cross the toes of a drag, but when I go in there at night, it's like opening a Mary Poppins bag.
Candy and pennies.
And crumbs. I got them heavy boobs, dance like dying stars. I got them heavy boobs, heavy boobs.
Ten pencils, paperback copy of Wuthering Heights,
soft remote control, hardback copy of Arabian Nights.
Oh my god! It's actually a nice bra in a decent size.
Nice!
Really nice!
How much is it?
£100.
Heavy boobs, heavy boobs. It's like a rental if I got them heavy boobs. Heavy boobs, me catch a fisherman's wharf if I got them heavy boobs. Heavy boobs. Don't ever forget that these heavy boobs are just sacks of yellow fat. Like the stuffing of a couch, they're just sacks of yellow fat. Technically meant to feed a baby, they're just sacks of yellow fat.
What?
Is to make sure I can read this. Okay. I told Julie I was going to do two contemporary love poems. In fact, I'm going to do four contemporary love poems. Loosely described. The reason for that is this. Those of you who've been to these things before will know that I usually read some very short poems. For the very good reason that it's very difficult, especially when people feel convivial, to listen for very long, and anything with any sort of complexity is lost completely. So just have to go and do something amusing. And the reality is that this year I found myself compelled to attempt something a little bit more, conceivably a tiny little bit more demanding in my two contemporary poems. So then I thought, but supposing it falls as flat as anything after six lines, it's going to be dreadful. So I'd better put some little short things in at the beginning so that, you know, they think I haven't lost it completely. So anyway, these poems are all love poems, and I'm a bit of a pedant, so I'm going to tell you what the object of the love is in case you don't get the point. I'm going to read the poems. So the first one of the short ones is by a friend of mine, actually, called Matthew Brown, Matt. And Matthew Brown is the vice chairman of Hackney Sporting Football Club, which plays on Hackney Marshes. And this little, well, it's almost a prose poem, really, is called Match Day at the Marshes. 17 seasons, 13 shorts, 13 shirts, 15 socks, goalie top, goalie gloves, 2 match balls, pump adapter, spare adapter, league match card, spare match card, first class stamp, training balls, ref's whistle, spare whistle, lino's flags, shin pads, spare pants, shower gel, team kit bag, first aid kit, my kit bag, corner flags, net ties, net pegs, mallet, pen, sandwich, towel, teapot, bottle, boots studded, boots molded, spare studs, stud key, sock ties, tracksuit, rule book, team sheet, keys, A to Z, check who's late, speak to subs, charm the ref, name the team, warm-up drills, pre-match talk, pre-match nerves, do the stretch, call the toss, last look round, shout out loud, breathe in deep, kick off, kick off, kick! Well, obviously he loves football. Second one is the only one, I'm afraid, this year by a woman, but one of my great favourites, so I've often read short poems by before, Wendy Cope, and this one speaks for itself, because it's called Valentine. My heart has made its mind up, and I'm afraid it's you. Whatever you've got lined up, my heart has made its mind up, and if you can't be signed up this year, next year will do. My heart has made its mind up, and I'm afraid it's you. Now we go to the ones which are, as it were, a bit more serious. The first one is by the Scottish poet Don Paterson, and it's called Waking with Russell. A tiny explanation. Because strangely, a lot of people don't understand what he's talking about the first time they read this, I've found, let alone hear it. But, you know, anyway, Russell is one of Don Paterson's sons, and, well, it's a love poem to his son, and the important thing is the age of the son in the event, which is the centre of the poem. Just another thing about it, it's got a bit of Italian in it, which literary and well-educated people know very well. But to be honest, when I read this poem, I didn't know it. Anyway, the phrase is mezzo del cammin, which means sort of halfway down the path, usually meaning the path of life. And it's a reference to Dante's famous poem, the beginning, when he's Dante, as a character in his own poem, is halfway through his life, age 35. And John Paterson was 35 at the time of the event, which is the central event of the poem. So it's called Waking with Russell. Whatever the difference is, it all began the day we woke up face to face, like lovers. And his four-day-old smile dawned on him again, possessed him till it would not fail or waver. And I pitched back not my old hard-pressed grin, but his own smile, or one I'd rediscovered. Dear son, I was mezzo del cammin, and the true path was as lost to me as ever when you cut in front and lit it as you ran. See how the true gift never leaves the giver. Returned and redelivered, it rolled on until the smile poured through us like a river. How fine, I thought, this waking amongst men. I kissed your mouth and pledged myself forever. The last poem is another one by Matthew Brown, written, I think, about 10 years ago, but remembering something for a few years earlier than that, which one reference to the poems in the poem suggests anyway. It's called Tell Me How London Feels. Now, probably most of you know that where London Fields is, apart from the Kingsley Amis novel, where it's somewhere else completely. You know, it's a park or rather an open space in Hackney. Something else I wanted to say about, oh yes. Well, I mean, I shouldn't say this before the poem really, but I can't help it. I think really there's two love objects in this poem, which is contemporary London and his partner. Tell me how London feels. Tell me of that day, how we watched a young mum push a double pram past the pub at the top of Broadway Market. How the 236 gasped to a stop, though the light was green, so the black woman bus driver could greet the Indian shop owner pulling in his Evening Standard sign saying, things can only get better. Tell me how London Fields was a beach browning under the swaggering sun. How two breathless girls in flip-flops and belly buttons snapped the caps off Smirnoff ice bottles on rusty railings around a scuffed snatch of ground. How a man played basketball with himself beneath hoops of green leaves and wispy clouds. Tell me how the sagging, sawn-off breaths of summer sucked into the last light of that rolled-up day. Tell me how dusk slipped into dark, and Hackney hummed in the shadow of lightning that shot across clouds of midnight air. Tell me how the laddered lights of tower blocks paved the grass with gold, and we looked for all the world at Blue Bridge and each other. How we heard the rumble of trains, of thunder, and saw the yellow light from windows reeling with life, flicking with wonder. Thank you.
I tell you, I almost didn't get here today.
Oh, what happened, Stuart?
I was in Sainsbury's.
Oh, lovely. Just
and this couple having a right barney.
How were they?
Oh, they were.
Oh.
One of them threw some fabric conditioner right at the other one.
You're joking me.
Yeah, completely missed them. Nearly hit me clean in the face, just whisked past my ear. Don't know what make it was, might have been Lenore, but it was too close for comfort. Told you they'd like it.
I told you they would do.
So I was running a bit late because of that, there's one more.
Okay.
So I rang for a limo for Gare in style. It's the Woodhouse Cabaret after all.
You are the host.
Yeah. Rang up, £300. Yeah, £300 limo.
Massive salary.
I've got the mic, shut up. Limo arrives. No driver.
Oh, no.
Yeah, £300, nothing to show for it. Please put your hands here and welcome back to the stage.
LJ.
LJ, thank you. LJ!
So I am going to do a song from my favourite musical of the last 5 years. The song is called Climbing Uphill. And I just wanted to dedicate it to anybody who's ever survived an audition, for one. Scary things. And to anyone who's ever chased a dream. Thank you. When you come home to me, I'll wear a sweeter smile and hope that for a while you... Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah. When you come home. I should have told them I was sick last week. They're gonna think this is the way I sing. Why is the pianist playing so loud? Should I sing louder? I'll sing louder. Maybe I should stop and start over. I'm gonna stop and start over. Why is the director staring at his crotch? Why is that man staring at my resume? Don't stare at my resume. I made up half my resume. Look at me, stop looking at that. Look at me. No, not at my shoes. Don't look at my shoes. I hate these fucking shoes. Why'd I pick these shoes? Why'd I pick this song? Why'd I pick this career? Why? Does this pianist hate me? If I can call back, I can go to IKEA with Mom and buy a couch. Not that I want to spend a day with Mom, but Jamie needs his space to write. Since I'm obviously such a horrible and annoying distraction to him, what's he going to be like when we have kids? And once again, why am I working so hard? These are the people who cast Russell Crowe in a musical. Jesus Christ, I suck, I suck, I suck. When finally you come home to me. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. I will not be the girl stuck at home in the burbs with the baby, the dog, and the garden of verbs. I will not be the girl in the sensible shoes, pushing burgers and beer nuts and missing the clues. I will not be the girl who gets asked how it feels to be trotting along at the genius's heels. I will not be the girl who requires a man to get by. And I... Thank you.
Sun lounger again, haven't you? As you call it, assistant stage manager. Model.
I don't know if you blob and get all sensitive, just because you struggle with auditions and that meant something to you, that last song. She wrote that joke and told me to say it. And he made me do it.
Say what? Next on the stage, I'll get the props ready. We've got Richard coming to the stage.
This is a tribute to Woodhouse players, front of house, all those people who operate the box office on a show night. It's 5 to 8 on a Saturday. We're just about to open. There's 5 minutes to go before the show starts. It's those last few moments of those last few people arriving for the show. Hello, good evening. Welcome to the Woodhouse Players. Hello. What's the name? Hi. Two, is it? You've already paid? Oh, lovely. That's fine. Would you like a programme? At 50p. Okay, that's lovely. Thank you very much. Enjoy the show. So, hello, good evening. Welcome to the Woodhouse. Yes. What's the name? Sorry, what was that? Murray, you said. You booked it? On the phone? Left a message on the phone? We've got Muhammad. We've got Murdoch. No, no. Mooney? No, you look like a Mooney? No. No Murray, I'm afraid. No. Oh, you could be just a Mooney for this evening. How about that? Oh, don't worry. It's £9. What's the programme? £9.50. Okay, thank you very much. Enjoy the show. Good evening. Sorry for keeping you. Welcome to the Woodhouse. What's the name? Oh, you've already booked. Ah, yes. Ah, right. Is this, are you related to Tom in the show? Oh, you're his parents. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, you must be so proud. It's so good. It's so good. Oh, yes, I saw him last night on the show. Oh, fantastic, yes. I think the full face mask really works for him. No, I think so. I think he's got great potential. I mean, hopefully in the next show he'll have a line. And you want a programme each, won't you, of course? A wonderful souvenir for yourself. Can be a pound, please. Thank you very much. Enjoy the show. Hello, good evening. Yes. What's the name? Oh, you haven't booked? Okay. That's fine. That's no problem. Yes. Sorry, what was that? Yes, we do have an interval, yes. It's about 15 minutes, just one interval. No, we don't serve ice cream during the interval. No, but we do have some lovely cakes. Yes. So, what are the cakes? Let me just check for you. Jackie! What cakes have you got tonight? Salted caramel cupcakes. Oh, they sound delicious. Gluten-free. What's that? Chocolate brownie. Oh, we've got very posh now, haven't we? What's that? Oh, lemon drizzle cake. Oh. What was that? You want me to ask whether gluten-free really is gluten-free? Jackie! Gluten-free. You sure it's gluten-free? What's that? It's from Tesco, so it must be right. Okay, then that's lovely. Yes, thank you very much. Yes, all the way through there, yes. Enjoy the show. Oh, the last person, yes. We're just about to start, yes. What was that? Oh, you haven't booked. Okay, no, that's fine. The play, yes. No, it's a great play. Who's the writer? It's Shakespeare. William Shakespeare. No, I wouldn't say he's a local writer. or up and coming either. No, I wouldn't call him as an up and coming writer. No, he's quite well known. Yeah. He's done a few things. Bit of comedy, bit of serious stuff, literary degree. So. No, you're not familiar? No, doing that? Something like to be or not to be, that is the question? Doesn't ring a bell? No? Now is the winter of our discontent. No, doesn't work. But don't worry anyway, I'm sure it'll be great. I'm sure you'll enjoy it. No, it's not a panto. No, it's fine. You'll enjoy it. No, that's £9. And programme, I'd read the programme if I were you. Yes, £9.50 in the show. Right, that's it. Right, that's all it. That's it now. We're finished now. Jackie, I could murder a cup of tea.
Sensei Kimber.
Welcome everyone. I'm glad you're all here on this government-inducing maths training course. I'm sure every single one of you parents, teachers and others have gone to the embarrassing situation of being unable to teach your children's arithmetic homeworks, or even teach maths for that matter. Due to the new system the government created last week, known as the new maths. So as a public service here tonight, I would like to teach you a little bit. We're going to go through subtraction. This is the first hall I've ever been in where I have not been able to provide a blackboard, so we will have to make do with more primitive situations. Guys! Consider the following equation, which I will present here. 342 minus 173. Now remember how we used to do that. Three from two is nine, carry the one, and if you're under 35 or went to a public school, you say seven from three is six. But if you're over 35 and went to a private school, you say 8 from 4 is 6. carry the one, and you get 169. But in the real new approach, as you all will know, the idea is to understand what you're doing rather than to get the right answer. Here's how they do it now. You can't take take 3 from 2, 2 is less than 3, so you look at the 4 in the tens place. Now that's really 4 tens, so you make it 3 tens, regroup, and you change the 10 to 10 ones, and you add them to the 2 and get 12, and you take away 3, that's 9, is that clear? Now instead of 4 in the tens place, you got 3 because you added 1, that is the same 10 to the 2, but you can take 7 from 3, so you look at the... Please be serious. From the 3, you then use 1 to make 10 ones. You know why 4 plus minus 1 is plus 10 is 14 minus 1 because addition is commutative. Right, and so you've got 14 tens, you take away 7, and that leaves 5. Well, 6 actually, but the idea is the important thing. Now go back to the hundreds place, you're left with 2, you take away 1 from 2, and that leaves.
One.
Everyone get one? Yeah. Not bad for the first day. Hooray for new math, it won't do you a bit of good to review math. It's so simple, so very simple, that only a child can do it. Now, that actually is not the answer that I had in mind, because the book that I got this problem, hang on, I need to remember the puzzle. The book that I got this puzzle from wants you to do it in base 8. But don't panic. Only Phil will know this. Base 8 is like base 10, really. If you're missing 2 fingers. Should we have a go at it?
Yeah.
Hang on. You can take 3 from 2, 2 is less than 3, so you look at the 4 in the 8th place. Now that's really 4 8s, you make it 3 8s, regroup, and you change the 8 to 8 once, and you add them to the 2 and get to a... You add them to the 2 and you get 1 2 base 8, or which is 10 base 10, you take away 3, that's 7, okay? Now it's over 4 in the 8th place, you've got 3 because you've added 1, that is to say 8 to the 2, but you can take 7 from 3, so you look at the 64s. How did 64 get into this? I need to cry. Well, 64 is 8 squared, don't you see? Look, you came to ask a silly question, you're only going to get a silly answer. From the 3, you then use 1 to make 8 ones, you add those 1s to the 3, so you get 1 3 base 8, or in other words, in base 10 you get 11, you take away 11, and 7 from 11 is 4. Now go back to the 64s, you're left with 2, and you take away 1 from 2, and that leaves...
1.
One. Now let's not always see the same hands, come on. One, that's right. Whoever got one can stay after the show and clean the whiteboard. Hooray for new math, it won't do you a bit of good to review math. It's so simple, so very simple, that only a child can do it. But as every one of you in the hall know, I hate maths.
Please welcome to the stage, No Room at the Inn.
We're just going to use your imagination to pretend that we're 30 years younger than we are.
What? What? What?
So 10!
So minus 5?
Oh, well, girls. Where's my wine glass? Great. It's about time that I reassess my life. Day's been gone 2 years now. I guess it's time to move on. I'll tell you what I've been thinking of doing. I've got a vacant room. I'm going to let it out. It's just lying there waiting, and it's going to change the whole life of one individual on this planet. Yes, it is. Yeah, I'm going to make a difference to their life. Now, of course, the money this enterprise gives me will change my life as well. Because I believe that before you can receive, you need to relax and give. Then you might make the perfect attachment, and that I will certainly make.
Oh, Holly, how I admire your selfless attitude. And that mode of existence would never do for me. I am a lone child of God. I live alone. I need to be free of all ties to grow and expand in individuality. Privacy is ecstasy. I could never bear to share my existence with a being of whom I had no prior knowledge or understanding. It would be like having an alien from outer space in your home. The chance of meeting a singular spirit is too remote to think of.
Are you prattling?
waffling on about? We're all the same underneath. Oh, look, Holly, if you want to let your room, good luck to you. But don't expect too much. It's not a love affair, you know. Listen, the school reunion's coming up in a fortnight's time. I've heard that the hotel's fully booked and people are looking for places to stay. Give the school a ring. It'll only be for the weekend. Then, if you like the letting, well, you can do it on a bigger scale.
Wow, thanks, Carol. I'll give them a ring.
Yes, hiya. I need a room for two nights. Yeah, well, it can't be easier than that to remember, can it? Well, what do you mean everything's full up? Well, I can't believe that anyone would want to visit that dump. And yes, I am talking about the hotel as well. I know about that school reunion. That's why I'm going. No, I haven't got any old friends I can stay with. Well, if that's all there is, well then, yes, all right, we'll have that. Oh, you can take my partner's name. It's Carpenter. Joe Carpenter. We'll be there about 6 on Friday. Joe, I found somewhere that we can stay, but it's in somebody's house.
What do you mean, someone's house? What's wrong with a local hotel? I can just see you happy in someone else's home.
Well, the hotels are all full, so we're staying at Mrs. Taverner's, or Taverner's. I know where it is. It's in Church Street, right next to the school.
Well, at least I'll be able to have a drink and not worry about driving. Remember, Mary, it's only 2 nights. Even you can put up with any old curtains for that length of time. But are you sure that you really want to go? I thought you never liked school.
Well, I didn't, but that's more the reason for my return. Oh. I can just imagine their faces. It's been 10 years since I've left that place, and when I walk in that room with my rich, handsome partner and a baby on the way, no one will believe it. Me, Mary Mandolin, poor old end of town, bottom set at maths, second-hand clothes, no boyfriend. Well, one of the teachers said I might do okay, but nobody else. But I've got you, babe. I've got you, babe.
Look, you two better go and get yourself prepared for this reunion tonight, hadn't you? I've got the Carpenters arriving any time now.
Carpenter, that's a nice name. Didn't you call anyone with that name in our year?
Holly, maybe this is the couple whose life you're going to make a difference to. Imagine they turn up truly amazed by your decor. They decide to stay for a year, and Mr. Carpenter has a most amazing brother. It could be written in your stars.
Oh, Ivy, you started reading Mills and Boone. Oh, I'm so pleased you've given Shakespeare a rest. Put you more on a footing with the rest of us mere mortals. Holly, you're right. Come on, Ivy, you need to put your war paint on tonight. Let's see Holly on her own to meet her guests.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Taverner. I'm Mr. Carpenter. Call me Joe.
Oh, nice to meet you. Where's Mrs. Carpenter?
Well, actually, it's not Mrs. Carpenter. She's just coming.
You!
You two know each other?
Oh, yes. This little snide's in my class.
Me? A little snide? Mary Mandolin, that class creep. She stole the answers to the second year exam and couldn't even write them down correctly. She still came last.
Holly, nay, Smith, obviously couldn't keep your man. Nothing changes. Remember Martin Knowles? I seem to remember him coming round to me for a quick snog, because you weren't very good at it then either. And looking at this decor, your taste's not improved either. God, what a dump.
What are you carrying?
Well, I've got some cleaning stuff with me, and I wasn't wrong, was I? And that was even before I knew you lived here. Look, if you think I'm staying here tonight, well then you've got another thing coming.
Are you paying enough, sir?
Oh, it's freezing outside. Couldn't wait to get back into the hall. Kept warm.
Well, it'll be interesting to see who turns up. I can't wait to see if Jane Nelson comes. Do you remember her always answering the teacher's back?
Yes, I do. And how about Martin Knowles? I'd love to see him again. Oh. Oh, my God! I don't believe it!
Oh, no, it wasn't bloody easy creeping into the hotel toilets to get changed. That's the least of our problems. Where are we staying tonight? Any ideas?
Look who it is! And she's got a blow.
And she's pregnant. Shouldn't be allowed. Poor would-be child.
I wonder where she's staying.
That's the carpenters. And they were staying at my place.
No.
Yes. And she's not changed a bit.
Were staying?
Yes. She flounced out before I could throw her out.
I wonder which poor unfortunate has the pleasure of her company now.
I've no idea. But as long as it's not me, I don't care. Look out, here they come.
Well, hello, Carol. Still the same as ever. Always the one who gets others to do all the work. And Ivy, still boring everybody with your wordy accounts of the world, are you? Well, it's nice to see that you've all done so well for yourselves. Designer clothes, husbands with Ferraris, semi-detached houses, just like you said you would. Oh, by the way, let me introduce my fiancé, Joe Carpenter.
Oh, hello, ladies. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, Mary. Nice to see you again. Just out of interest, where are you staying tonight?
Well, after a rather unfortunate error, Joe and I found an excellent little place, just to our taste, didn't we, darling?
Yes, dear, we did.
That's very fortunate.
Oh, my God, Joe. Ah, help me. Oh, no, I think the baby's coming. Help!
Get a doctor!
Time passes. Thank God. A healthy baby boy. Born in a school toilet. Must have been a first. No one but Mary Magdalene could do that. You'd have thought it though. You'd think they could take her to hospital. It's a good job you've got somewhere decent. They've got somewhere decent to stay the night, Joe.
Thinking of that. Just try not to obsess her too much at the moment. Look. Anyway, she just made it up.
Well, I suppose under the circumstances, you could go to stay at my place.
Well, thank you so much, but I did say I was going to ask you if it would be possible. I don't know how to tell you this, but she said she'd rather sleep in the shed.
That's all very well, but what about the baby? That's your baby as well, you know.
Yes, I am thinking of that. I'm just trying not to upset her too much at the moment. Look, I better get back to her and come and see the baby. Letting us stay last night. Thanks for sorting the baby out. I just never thought that Mary would be this stubborn.
Well, I hope that even she had as comfortable a night as possible in that shed. It's nobody's fault but her own. She was offered a bed.
Well, no way was I having the baby sleep in there. Why should I let her stay with me when she's been so pig-headed and stupid? That really made me see the light. I'm finished with her. Plus, she says she wants nothing more to do with the baby. I can't believe it took 2 hours. 2 hours is the shortest period of motherhood I've ever heard of. Anyway, she can take herself out of that shed and back home anytime she likes, but I won't be joining her.
Well, I have just bought a small present for the baby, Joe. I thought you might need a pack of nappies.
I'll give you a cuddly toy. And actually, over in the cupboard, there's a week's supply of powdered milk.
Yeah, you're very kind. And yes, Holly, I'm taking up your offer. Baby Lou and I are staying here with you for as long as you'll have us.
We now are going to have our last act for the first half. Aww. But don't worry, we'll be back for more Stuart's jokes. So we've now got Ashley and Alex singing some songs.
Alex is not singing.
Just Ashley singing.
And he's whistling. At the interval, remember to get your raffle tickets, and the raffle will be drawn at the interval. Is that right?
We'll draw at the end.
We'll draw the raffle. But buy your raffle tickets during the interval.
Yay!
Are you guys ready?
Are you going to be much longer?
Did I tell you I found out the real names of my grandparents today? That's a joke. Yeah. No? Grandma was called Pearl. Grandfather was called Dean. I only knew it was Grandma and Grand. Papa.
Oh, you're ready. Oh, good.
Ashley and Alex.
Hello.
We're ready. I meant to do that.
All intentional noises. Oh, yeah. Sorry, I have no jokes. Okay. Let's go. So polite, you could offer a light. Start a little conversation.
just about.
You bay. Send me on my way. Send me on my way.
In the second half, so that's it. See you in a bit.